Hello and welcome to the City of Anderson's Black History Month program in conjunction with Allen Chapel AME Church. I am Tammy Dixon Tatum, the City of Anderson's Civil and Human Rights Director, and I bring to you some history about Black History Month. Black History Month, or African American History, was originated in the United States and began as a way of remembering important people and events in the history of the African diaspora. Black history is celebrated during the whole month of February each year. This recognition of the African American began as a week-long event to remember and acknowledge the accomplishments of African Americans and the importance of their contributions to the United States of America. Historian Carter G. Woodson and the Association for the Study of Negro Life and History created this week-long event in 1926, and they proclaim the second week of February to be Negro History Week. This week was chosen because it coincided with the birthday of Abraham Lincoln on February the 12th and Frederick Douglass on February the 20th. Both dates, for years, Black communities had celebrated together since the late 19th century. At the time of Negro History Week's launch, Woodson contended that teaching of Black history was essential to ensure physical and intellectual survival of the Black race within broader society. He said, "If a race has no history, it has no worthwhile tradition. It becomes a negligible factor in the thought of the world, and it stands in danger of being exterminated." From the event's initial phase, primary emphasis was placed on encouraging the coordinated teaching of African American history in the nation's public schools. Churches also played a significant role in the distribution of literature in association with Negro History Week during the initial intervals, with mainstream and Black press both aiding in publicity efforts. Negro History Week grew into Black History Month, and this month-long event was proposed by Black educators and Black United students at Kent State University in 1969, actually in February of 1969. The first celebration of Black History Month took place at Kent State 1 year later, from January the 2nd to February the 28th of 1970. Black history is American history, and Anderson's Black history is our history too. Therefore, I bring to you Anderson's Backyard History, Black History in the Making with Our Youth, in part one of our recognition program, which highlights the accomplishments, culture, and importance of Anderson's African American contributions to Anderson, Indiana, and to the United States. Again, welcome to Anderson's Backyard Black History Program, where we are embracing, producing, reproducing, and showcasing Anderson's Black history, and Black excellence. We have a whole lineup of youthful dreamers, and they are here to share with you their contributions to Black history and Anderson's Black history. Thank you all for joining us today, and thank you to all of the dreamers for not only dreaming, but for coming out and sharing your contribution to America's history and Anderson's history. Thank you all so much. And everyone, again, please enjoy our program. Again, this is only part one. We will have part two coming out next week, so please stay tuned. But for now, thank you for your attendance, and please enjoy. One last word. I want to give a special thanks to Pastor Trotter from Allen Chapel AME Church, Miss Marilyn Goree, Miss Kim Vaughn, and our very own, Anderson's very own, Nick Harder. Thank you all so much, and please enjoy the show.
At this time, we will have a prayer by Pastor Trotter from Allen Chapel AME Church.
Hello, I'm Pastor Dalray Trotter, and I bring you greetings from Allen Chapel, African Methodist Episcopal Church. Will you join me in a season of prayer? Let us go now to the throne of grace and mercy. Let us pray. Gracious and eternal, everlasting and almighty, the giver of every good and perfect gift, we celebrate you today, and we thank you for this privilege, this opportunity to gather together, Lord God, for the celebration of Black history, the African American history. We invite you as we attempt to tell our stories, oh God. We invite your holy presence among us. We invite your holy presence, asking you, oh God, to bring with you the hopes, the joy, the strength of our ancestral past. We pray now, oh God, that you would touch hearts and minds of those of us who have gathered, that you would pour out your spirit, oh God, and give us that energy to celebrate, to remember, oh God, that we have come through the path of the blood of the slaughtered. We come now, oh God, to remind ourselves and to tell our stories just how good you've been to us throughout the years, through trial and tribulation, through struggle, oppression, inequalities. You were right there with us. And so we celebrate you today, asking you to pour out your Holy Spirit upon us. Touch the hearts of these young people who are gathered to celebrate and to tell their stories, oh God. We pray that you would bring with them renewed energy and renewed faith and strength, the hope of the past, oh God, that they might begin, oh God, to not only tell their stories, oh God, but to celebrate you continually and perpetually throughout time. We pray for the renewing of hearts and strengths, for the opening, oh God, of gifts. Pour out your spirit upon these young people, that we would begin to see a brighter future, Lord God, that they will continue, Lord God, to tap into the strength of the ancestral path, that they would begin, oh God, to continue to be determined, God, to give you their best, to celebrate you with creativity, Lord God, that they will continue to grow, God, and continue to contribute to society as a whole. We pray for the listening audience and those who have gathered, that hearts would be uplifted and opened up. Lord God, those who have been hurt and sorrowful from the past experiences, oh God, that they might be renewed today. Pour out your spirit upon this service today, that it would give you glory, that it would give you praise, that it would garner hope in us, that it would encourage us, oh God, that we would be ever more determined to make our way straight and to continue to give you glory and give you praise in all that we do. Come now and touch the hearts of those who are wearied and those who have been struggling. Come now and gather your people. Come now, gather us as one voice, that we will continue, Lord God, to build on today's events, that we will continue to celebrate you, celebrate each other, and build a better future. We thank you for what you're going to do in advance and for all that you've done in the past. We give your name glory. Have your way in this service. It is in the name of Jesus that we pray. Amen. Thank God and bless you. Have a great celebration. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Trotter. Next, we will have a little history on the Black National Anthem, then the Black National Anthem performed, followed by a few words from Tammy about the importance of preserving Black history.
There's been a lot of talk about the national anthem lately, for better or for worse. But for African Americans, there's a national anthem that goes way back and tells our American story of struggle, triumph, and freedom.
It's a part of me, it's a part of history.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring.
It's called Lift Every Voice and Sing.
I heard it actually going to my grandma's church.
I went to Spelman, so they were singing before sporting events.
Wasn't it an old slave song?
Lift Every Voice and Sing actually started as a poem. It was first recited in the year 1900 by 500 school children at the all-black Stanton School in Jacksonville, Florida, as a tribute to President Abraham Lincoln's birthday. The creator of Lift Every Voice and Sing was James Weldon Johnson, a civil rights activist, lawyer, and school principal, who also wrote the poem to introduce Booker T. Washington, who was visiting his school. Johnson's brother, John Rosamond Johnson, put the poem to music, and it officially became a song. Once the NAACP adopted Lift Every Voice and Sing as its official Negro national anthem, the song took on a life of its own. A remake of Lift Every Voice and Sing was done in the 1990s by Melba Moore with fellow R&B artists like Stevie Wonder, Anita Baker, Dionne Warwick, and Bobby Brown. It was even recited during President Barack Obama's first presidential inauguration. Wherever you stand on what to actually call Lift Every Voice and Sing, chances are you fall into the bucket of people who just remember the first stanza. Yeah.
Lift every voice and sing to wherever. Lift every voice and sing till our.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmony of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise
high as the listening skies.
I should resound as the rolling sea.
Beyond the politics around Lift Every Voice and Sing, the song itself is powerful in that it talks about staying hopeful, fighting injustice, and knowing the struggle our ancestors endured.
It's a part of something that gave people hope and, striving for excellence and kind of sense of community.
Just knowing that you have a, what do you want to call that? A place. Knowing that you're an individual, you're a citizen. You are here. You are here, and there's power in that.
Lift every voice and sing to earth and heaven. Tears have been still now we stand at last, where the white gleam of my star is cast. Our God, where we met thee, lest our hearts, drunk of the wine of the world, we forget thee. Shadow beneath thy hand, may we forever stand. Our God.
Black History is about preserving African American history by sharing our stories to honor the triumphs and the struggles of African Americans throughout U.S. history, including the Civil Rights Movement and our artistic, our cultural, our intellectual, our entrepreneurial, and our political achievements, both here in Anderson, Indiana, and throughout the U.S. Black History in the Making is honoring our past while embracing, producing, reproducing, and showcasing our current contributions to Anderson, Indiana, and throughout the U.S. Our African American ancestors were dreamers that got the job done with excellence in spite of their struggles. We, as African American descendants in Anderson, Indiana, are doing the same. In Anderson, Miss Bonnie White Collier is one of our local Black historians. She has preserved our local Black history for over a decade. Miss Bonnie says, knowing Black history is important to maintaining self-esteem and moving forward in a positive way. If we don't know our history, we lose self-respect and we lose the quality of our ancestors that came before us. Thank you, Miss Bonnie. Thank you for not allowing us to lose the quality of our ancestors. Thank you for preserving our local Black history. You and your hard work are greatly appreciated. Now, everyone, take a look. Look at our excellence through Anderson's Backyard, Black History, and Black History in the Making, Part 1.
Where is she?
I've been walking with my face turned to the sun. Wait on the shoulder.
Yeah.
like to pick a new name to mark your freedom.
Paraton.
Thank you.
We are by ourselves. I'm proud to be black. This is Black History Month, and my black is beautiful!
I am a dreamer, and my contribution to Black History Month is that I am an artist through drawing and poetry. Black history is more than the month of February. It is every second of every day. Black history has shaped the world as we know it today. Black history is Kamala Harris. Black history is Amanda Gorman. Black history is me. Blackness itself is history. So believe me when I say, Black history is every day.
I am a dreamer, and my contribution to Black history is I am a musician.
I'm a dreamer, and my contribution to Black history is I am a dancer and I am an artist. Here is this piece of artwork that I drew.
I'm a dreamer. My contribution to Black history is I play basketball, the aspiration to play professional basketball. I make all A's and I will be running my own business.
every voice and sing till earth heaven ring, ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies resound out the roar. That the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of our new day.
Wow. Just look at our excellence. Look at it. Just look at it. In closing, we must never forget that our ancestors of the past paved the way so that we descendants can be the dreamers and the achievers we are destined to be. I am because we are a collective community of greatness. Greatness that was shown on this program today. Greatness that's seen in our communities and communities across the U.S. each and every day. Lastly, we are seeking photos and stories about the Black community to add to our Black History collection. If you have any, please forward them to tdixontatum@cityofanderson.com. That's tdixontatum@cityofanderson.com. And thank you. Thank you all for joining us today for Anderson's Backyard Black History and Black History in the Making, Part 1. And stay tuned for Part 2 coming your way soon. Thank you.